represented here by Suraj Gola from Vidya School, Gurugram, are replicas of two terracotta figurines depicting a horse and a fierce-looking being, both of which form an important part of the Ayanar worship tradition. The artifacts are currently a part of the collections at the Sanskriti Museum of Indian Terracotta, Delhi. The tradition of Ayanar worship is predominantly practiced in southern India, where he is venerated as a village guardian deity. The roots of this practice can be traced to as early as the 3rd century CE. The figure of Ayanar is usually depicted as holding a crooked stick or a scepter in his hand, seated in a squatted position with the Yogapattam or meditation band around his knee. He is often depicted riding either an elephant or a horse. An inseparable part of the Ayanar shrines in the south are a fierce-looking demon that accompanies Ayanar as he guards the village and large terracotta horses. The artifacts depicted in this exhibition are representations of the companion of Ayanar and the horses offered to him. As a long-standing tradition, Ayanar is made offerings of clay and terracotta horses to make sure that the deity never falls short of steed during his guarding of the village. Made by a potter priest, the terracotta horses are made ceremoniously according to tradition of southern Indian art. These magnificent steeds can be found in abundance in villages and sacred groves across southern India. The next artifact is an 18th century Bhairava sculpture presented by Kashvi Jain from Chidi Goenka Public School, Jammu. The artifact is currently a part of the collection at the Dogra Art Museum, Jammu. The earliest mention to Bhairava can be traced back to the Puranic period. While different Puranas give a different narrative for the origin of Bhairava, all of them highlight his association with Shiva. Iconographical literature states that Bhairava is one of the Samhara Murtis of Shiva and may be shown in different forms. Each of these forms can be classified into separate categories based on their iconography. A very popular classification of the forms of Bhairava are the Ashtanga Bhairavas. Bhairava is usually depicted as a fierce deity with a flabby belly, round yellow eyes, tusks protruding from the sides of his mouth and wide nostrils. He is shown wearing a garland of skulls, adorned with snakes as ornaments, elephant skin as a garment, and bearing weapons. The sculpture of Bhairava presented here seems to be a part of a larger structure, with a substantial portion of the Bhairava being lost. It depicts Bhairava as a fierce being with four arms, a rounded belly, wearing a Yajnapavitam and adorned with ornaments. Beyond the association of Bhairava within the mainstream practice of Hindu theology, Bhairava garners a prominent position in the Trika system, where he represents the divine consciousness. The next artifact is a sculpture of the four-armed Chanda, a Buddhist deity, presented by Ayush Goel from DAV Public School, Ballabgarh. This sculpture dates approximately to the 11th century CE and is currently a part of the collection at the National Museum, Delhi. Chanda, as a deity, seems to have risen to popularity after she was adopted as the patron goddess by the Pala dynasty of Bengal. As per Buddhist sources, Chanda is considered as an embodiment of the Chanda Dharani. The Sadhana Mala text refers to Chanda as the only female emanation of Vajrasattva, while some texts attribute her parentage to Vairochana Buddha. Apart from this disparity, the iconography of Chanda varies from depicting her as a two-armed goddess seated in the Dhyana Mudra to having as many as 8 to 26 arms, each holding objects that reflect her attributes. The sculpture here depicts Chanda seated in the Padmasana. Two of her hands can be seen holding a bowl, while the other two can be seen holding a lotus flower and a rosary, objects which are recurring within the iconography of Chanda. This artifact, chosen and presented by Anushka Patel from Navy Children's School, Mumbai, is a coping stone from a stupa in Amravati, Guntur district, Andhra Pradesh. The artifact can be traced to the 2nd century CE and is currently a part of the collection at the Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj Vastu Sangrahalay, Mumbai. The Dona Sutta of the Anguttara Nikaya from the Sutta Pitaka, one of the canonical Buddhist texts, narrates an incident where the Buddha uses the analogy of the lotus to explain his enlightenment. Here, he states that, like the lotus which is born in muddied and stagnant waters, rises above the water untarnished by it, he too, being born in the world of suffering and impermanence, lived unsmeared by it. This analogy from the Buddhist canonical literature can be seen translated to the use of the lotus as a recurring motif in Buddhist art, not only to symbolize Buddha himself, but also as a representation of his enlightenment. The lotus flower is most often depicted as the seat of Buddha, reinforcing its association with the purity of mind and spiritual perfection. In Buddhist architecture, the lotus motifs can be seen extensively used as pillar capitals, pedestals, seats, and as medallions or coping stones called ushanisha found on the railings that surround the stupa. In case of their depiction on coping stones, the lotus flower is always shown in full bloom like the one seen on the artifact in this exhibit. The artifact presented by Ishan Bhalerao is a mutoscope that can be dated to the year 1900. The artifact is currently a part of the collection at the National Museum of Indian Cinema, Mumbai. The mutoscope is a manually operated early motion picture device invented by Hermann Gassler in the year 1959. The working of the mutoscope somewhat resembles the concept of a flipbook, where a series of cards in the device would flip to present moving reels. The cards were usually electrically lighted, but the reel was operated by a geared down hand crank. Each machine was designed to display a single reel and was dedicated to the presentation of a single short subject. Mutoscopes found popularity within arcades in Europe and the US for over a period of 20 years before they were gradually replaced, first by the 35mm longer narrative films and later by the television as the preferred form of entertainment. Despite their relatively short-lived circulation within the motion picture industry, the mutoscopes saw close to 4,000 titles and approximately 100,000 reels made to be displayed, making the device an important milestone in the development of the motion picture devices. Chosen and presented by Team MBS from the Navy Children's School, Mumbai, this artifact is a ceiling slab depicting Vishnu in a Sheshashayi form. The artifact can be dated to the 7th century CE and is currently a part of the collection at the Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj Vastu Sangrahalaya. Ancient Indian architectural texts mention Vishnu to be the only deity that is iconographically permitted to be depicted in a reclining posture. Such depictions of Vishnu are called Shayanamurtis. Vishnu in his Sheshashayi form is the primordial being who created the universe while resting in the Kshirasagara on Adi Shesha, the primordial serpent. The iconography of Sheshashayi Vishnu differs based on which subcategory of Shayanamurtis it has been made in. The artifact here depicts Vishnu resting on Shesha with one hand supporting his head and the others resting on the serpent beneath him. He is adorned with the Kirita Mukuta, the Yajna Pavita, armlets, bracelets and a necklace of coins. Vishnu's ayudhas or weapons, the chakra and gada, are placed horizontally near his right hand while the shankha is near his left hand. The goddesses Shri Devi and Bhu Devi can be seen seated beside Vishnu, with Garuda being depicted in the right corner. Mutilated figures of Madhu and Kaitabha are placed on the top. The slab is bordered on two vertical sides by meandering floral scrolls. The next artifact, presented by Team NCSRAA from the Navy Children's School, Mumbai, is a fragment of a Prabhavali. This artifact can be dated approximately to the 13th-14th century CE. The artifact, which was once a part of a Jain temple at Supara, is currently located in the Center for Extramural Studies at the University of Mumbai, Kalina campus. Prabhavali, also known as Prabhavalaya, refers to the ornate arch that is usually depicted around the figure of any deity. Prabhavalis usually bear icons and figures that depict legends related to the deity or those that are in veneration of the central deity. This fragment in the first row depicts male figurines seated with their hands in the Namaskar Mudra. The second row of the Prabhavali features an elephant in motion. While the section of the Prabhavali that shows the elephant in its entirety is broken, it is believed that the complete image shows the elephant's trunk holding a garland raised in offering. The last row of the artifact consists of a pair of male and female figurines holding garlands. These are known as Maladharas. Apart from highlighting the central deity, Prabhavalis prove to be an excellent example of the exceptional craftsmanship, intricacy, and diversity found in Indian art and architecture. The artifact chosen and presented by Team Teen Seekers from Mayur School, Noida, is a statue of Kubera, the god of wealth in the Hindu pantheon. This artifact is presently a part of the collection at the National Museum, Delhi, and can be dated back to the 2nd century CE. Kubera first finds mention in the Vedic literature. Here, he is mentioned as the chief of the spirits of darkness or as the lord of thieves and criminals. It is only in the Puranic and epic literature that Kubera is truly venerated as the god of wealth. It is also during this period that Kubera gains the status of being a Dikpala or a guardian deity of the north. This sculpture depicts Kubera as a figure with a rounding belly, seated in the Bhadrasana or the butterfly pose, adorned by a necklace of thick twisting bands of pearls and sporting a bow-like mustache. The sculpture stylistically can be attributed to the Mathura school of art. Archaeological evidences suggest that the sculptures belonging to the Mathura school of art were found from Takshila in the northwest to Chandraketugad in the east, suggesting widespread acceptance of the Mathura style of art during this period. This artifact, presented by Team Kalam Kamal from the Chennai Public School, is a bronze idol of Ardhanarishvara. Excavated in Thiruvengadu, the idol is currently a part of the collection of the Government Museum, Chennai. The artifact can be dated back to the 11th century CE, with its craftsmanship being attributed to the Chola dynasty. While the idea of a combined duality appears within the Indian subcontinent as early as the Vedic period, the present-day concept of Ardhanarishvara was developed only in the Puranic period. The iconography of Ardhanarishvara usually depicts the right half as Shiva and the left half as Parvati. The artifact here depicts a three-armed Ardhanarishvara. The right half of the statue represents Shiva wearing a Jata Mukuta with a crescent moon, a Yajnopavitam resting against the hip, which is encircled by a girdle of serpents, and a short garment that ends above the knee. In contrast, the left half represents Parvati wearing a Karanda Mukuta, the left ear bearing a Kundala, elaborate ornaments covering the torso, and a garment draped from the waist to the knee. One of the three arms, one arm on the right holds the Parshu or the axe, while the other is bent lower as if resting, usually on a Nandi, while the arm on the left is positioned as if holding something. A reference to this image can be found in the temple at Thiruvengadu where the idol was excavated. This artifact of the Vrishanina Yogini or the buffalo-headed Yogini is presented by Team The Antiquitarians from Mayur School, Noida. This sculpture traces its origin approximately to the 10th century CE and belongs to a group of 20 Yogini sculptures that were a part of the Lokhari temple in Uttar Pradesh. The Yogini tradition is said to have stemmed from village cult goddesses before it was incorporated within the practice of Tantra. A very common aspect observed in the Yogini tradition is that of depicting the Yoginis with heads of various animals. The Vrishanina Yogini, like most Yogini sculptures, depicts her as a beautiful bodied woman adorned with jewelry. As the name suggests, the Vrishanina Yogini is shown having the head of a buffalo. Seated on the Lalitasana on a swan as her vahan, she holds a club in her right hand and a bilva fruit in the left hand. An interesting fact remains that after its removal from the Lokhari temple in the late 1980s, this sculpture was recovered and repatriated by the Embassy of India, Paris in 2013. Since then, this sculpture has been on display in the National Museum, Delhi.